New York Times had an article. There was an apartment building in Manhattan, and there were happily married couples there. And these people were very, very much part of the success scene. Things were going well for them. And they came home at night after their lovely jobs and had lovely marriages. And one day there was a couple there that got a divorce. And the husband moved out, and the wife began talking with her friends and pointing out, you know, your husband doesn't respect you, your husband, yeah. Another divorce. Then the people began to realize, says the New York Times article, that this is a contamination. You talk to these divorced ladies, you're going to get a divorce too. And they tried to block them up, but they couldn't, again and again. Watch out from this. Someone is divorced. Has to spread the news, and has to spread the anger at husbands. Doesn't respect you or the wife. When your wife doesn't respect you, just listen. Just listen. It's so sensitive and so delicate. You hear one person criticize your wife. Ooh, you hear one person criticize your husband. Especially if it's a close friend of yours. Especially if it's a relative. That's how he treats you. That's how she treats you. Ooh, that's all that you need. And then you become aware that maybe, maybe. So it's very hard today, and you have to be careful when you get these messages to block them out, or your life can be jeopardized. And let's talk about now about when it comes to the end, when there is a divorce. Obviously, there's a lot to say about pre-divorce and after divorce. We're going to say a few things here. We have a short video. We're going to keep it short. To make the point that I want to make, you've got to realize that there's the external and the internal. Out there, you can't change. And yeah, maybe the relationship with your spouse, you can't change either. It's possible you can't change it. But one thing you can change and control to some degree is you, the internal. When your internal is plugged into the external, so that every time somebody does something, you react. Damn, I'll get it back. Then you become a hater. That's the end of your life. But on the other hand, if you could somehow extricate your internal from what's going on, a little praying, a little trying to understand what is happening with your life, maybe some professional counseling, how to deal with the problems, try to get the other person to the professional counselor or to the rabbi and knows how to talk about these issues successfully, then you're fighting for yourself. And you know something else? You're fighting for your children and for your parents and for your relatives. Because everyone is affected by a divorce. The whole family trembles. The children, disaster. Therefore, when you see that things are going down the drain, don't let your heart go down the drain. Don't let your soul go down the drain. Get yourself some counseling. Get yourself people who will make sure that you don't fall apart and become a hater. Because if you become a hater, you ruin your own life. But if you hold on there, even if there's a divorce, sometimes a husband can be a rotten person. Now, there are rotten husbands, or a wife is a rotten person. I see the other person is holding it in, not letting out the anger. They have, there's a part of them that says, you know, I got to be a mensch, I got to be a person. I've got to make it a smooth landing as much as possible. Or maybe they can even change their ways and improve the marriage. A lot can be done by a person that holds it in, but a person that lets it out becomes a hater and becomes very lively in that place. Ends up with the lawyers. Somebody told me he just spent $50,000. Now, I don't know about you, but I would hope I wouldn't have to spend $50,000 on a divorce. Not just part of the payment. When it gets nasty, the money just flows away. Your whole life, the equity in your house, your savings, this flows out with the litigations, with the fighting. The lawyers just, oh, they're so happy when someone has to be a divorce. Then they go to Florida every week. And people's hard-earned money just flows out. And the time and energy for the courts and the chicks and what's this. And the poor children. What is a divorce? If you've had a decent ending of your marriage because you retained your decency, That's the best you can do, is retain your decency. And then you're a person of peace and love, positive, come to the divorce. Don't be tricky, don't be clever, don't listen to all these people walking around giving you advice how to hurt. You make sure you ask the right people for advice how to proceed. Try to get a peaceful divorce. Don't play these games, especially the ladies have the power to put their husbands in jail. It's a whole thing today. A lady told me she got her husband arrested. He gets out of jail. He says, "You put me in jail?" And he says, "I know a few things." So the lady comes running to me. "Rabbi!" So I called them both to my house. We discussed this. I said, "Where did you get this idea to put your husband in jail? Is he such an awful husband? It seems that she wanted to remain married to him." She said, "Well, these ladies told me to do it. They said if your husband doesn't behave, then you get power over him by putting him in jail. That's what you're supposed to do." And so ladies walking around our community telling ladies to go put their husbands in jail. And they don't realize the husband gets out of jail and he might be able to do a few things too, and you're not going to like it. Unfortunately, this is not part of the culture. Put your husband in jail. Make an order of protection so that one lady got an order of protection against her husband, and whenever there was a PTA meeting and the husband came to see his children, she showed up and called the police and got the husband put in jail. He was in jail 3 times. And there was another man that I met who was in jail 7 times. Lady has great power. Order of protection. He's threatening me. He's fighting me. Put him in jail. Well, you could try that. But you should know. You hurt somebody. Talmud says, don't start up with a small snake because one day it'll be a big snake. Don't start up with someone because you have the upper hand. You never know when the other guy's going to have the upper hand. And they're not going to forget what you did. So, if you have a peaceful divorce, then you don't have to live in fear the rest of your life. But if you don't have a peaceful divorce, the rest of your life, ooh, what's going to happen? What's he going to do? What's he going to say? You know, a divorced man, a divorced woman, they want to remarry. And you know something? I'll tell you a terrible secret. If there's a divorce and the people want to remarry, the person that they meet, the person of their dreams who's everything that the ex is not, is going to run to your ex and ask information. And if you are playing hate, they're going to get an earful. But if you played it straight, the husband and the wife split, and each one says, "I didn't merit to have a good marriage with that person." But how decent they were after all the pain of the divorce, where all these spouses are running around destroying the other one, ripping off their money, destroying their custody rights, whatever mean thing they could do. And this, my spouse, my ex, was decent and understanding. With all the pain, I'm going to be decent too. I'm going to give a good report. I'm going to say to people who ask, "Marry that person. I didn't merit a good marriage with them, but look how decent they were at the divorce." And when people hear decent at a divorce, this is for me. So this is why the difference between hate and love is your own remarrying. Remember, you must be married. If this marriage doesn't work out, you must remarry. And to remarry, you must have a good name. And to have a good name, remember, whoever wants to marry you is going to ask your ex and their family and their friends, "Tell me the inside story why there was a divorce." They say, "You know, the two didn't get along. They tried, they're decent people, but they weren't. Okay, that sounds good. That sounds very good." Or else it could be, how do you think a marriage can last with such a person? Oh, I don't want to marry someone like that. So the people that have it out, that have a bad divorce, these people are ruining their lives.